All right, guys, Gilbert Burns here again. You guys know, in the training camp, February 13th, UFC 258, I'll be facing Kamaru Usman for the world title. And I'm just taking a little time here, talk with my fans, talk with the subscribers on my channel. And I got a good topic today. You know, guys, we're going to talk about 170 division, dark horse on that division. And I got three guys that I think are the dark horse right there. People don't talk very much about them, but I think they're very dangerous, a good potential. And number one, I think it's Vicente Luque, friend of mine, a beast. Great stand-up, great chin, hits hard, a lot of finishes in the UFC, couple knockouts, couple submissions. And I do think he's very underrated, you know, because it's hard to give him a top 10 opponent, top 5 opponent. The only one that he fought was on the top 5 was Wonderboy. He lost, but a good fight. Other than that, he just fighting everyone outside of the rank, you know, and then he's waiting for a ranked opponent right now. But I think people don't say his name so much, but I do believe he's the dark horse in that division. Another dark horse, not that much, will be Khamzat Chimaev, but he's already got a good fight in front of him that we will see if he's, you know, he's real or not. I believe he's real. I believe he's going to beat Leon Edwards this March. I think the fight was rescheduled. We're going to see. We're going to see on this one. Khamzat might be my second dark horse in that division. And third, number three dark horse in that division, I think, is Niel Magny. You know, he's always good, always game, beat a lot of guys. I call him out a couple of times. Never had an opportunity to fight him. One day we will fight. I believe we will fight Niel Magny sooner than later. I just can't see fighting Niel Magny later round. Maybe next year. I don't know. I do believe I'm fighting Niel Magny one day. And I think he's a dark horse. He's got a big fight right now. Michael Chiesa, main event in Fight Island. I do believe Michael Chiesa can win this fight if he can grapple, start a lot of grappling actions with Niel Magny. But if the fight keep on the stand, I think on the striking, on the stand, I think Niel Magny got the advantage. I do believe Michael Chiesa can win and maybe will win. I'm a little 50-50 on that fight. Depends on which guy shows up, like, hungry. I think Niel Magny is very hungry, so Chiesa is, but I think it's going to be a lot of style on the matchup. If he goes to the ground, Chiesa for sure. If they stand, I would say Niel Magny. But I do believe Niel Magny is not a dark horse in that division, so I don't know. Let's see what's next for Vicente Luque. You know, I think he deserves a top 10 guy. I don't know who. If you saw the top 10, we got Niel Magny fighting Chiesa, then we got Damian Maia, then we got Tyron Woodley, then Wonderboy, then start, you know, and Masvidal and Leon Edwards and all these guys. I don't know if they're going to fight Luque right now, but I do believe Luque, he deserves a top 10 opponent. If he will get, I don't know, I hope he does. Khamzat is already fighting Leon Edwards. We're going to watch this one, and Niel Magny and Chiesa, I'll be watching this one very, very closely. Any fight at 170, I'm right there looking, you know, studying, make my notes, you know, and analyzing the fight, not just watching. I like to watch and see what these guys are doing different, what the coach is telling him, you know, the way they see the fight. I'm always game. I'm always looking for that. And that's it. Those are my top three dark horse on the welterweight division. Let me know if you guys, what you guys like. Comments below. Subscribe right now. Talk to you guys soon.